GVol's lesson on realized volatility, also known as historical volatility. Today we're going to explore what does it mean and how do we calculate it. Historical volatility is how the underlying asset has actually moved in the past. How volatile was the underlying asset? One of the important things about the Black-Scholes formula is that it calculates the implied volatility. The implied volatility is the options market best estimate or current market price estimate of the future realized volatility of the underlying asset. This is why calculating realized volatility is so important. It gives us a really good context around how volatile the asset can be and whether the options market's estimate is in line or not. Unlike spot prices, historical volatility is not directly observable. It needs to be calculated. It's often quoted as the one-year standard deviation of continuously compounded returns. Calculating realized volatility or historical volatility is part art and part science. There's a lot of common equations that we can use, but there's a lot of assumptions that we need to make as well. For example, do we assume a 365-day calendar year, or do we assume a 252-day trading year? One of the most common methods of calculating realized volatility is to use the daily close-to-close method. This looks at the continuously compounded returns from one day to the next. The first step to calculating the close-to-close method is to back out continuously compounded returns from the price relative of one day to the next. So that would be the LN of today's price divided by yesterday's price. Once we've calculated a string of continuously compounded returns, the second step is to choose a calculation window. Do we want to calculate the standard deviation for 30 consecutive returns or 180? Once we've made that decision, we can calculate the standard deviation. The third step after calculating our standard deviation will be to annualize it. Because we're dealing with daily returns, we would take the standard deviation times the square root of 365, which is the amount of calendar days, or standard deviation times the square root of 252, which is the amount of trading days. One last thing to note is that you don't need to use daily returns. You can use hourly, weekly, or monthly. Just make sure to appropriately annualize your standard deviation. There are many other ways to calculate historical volatility. Because GVol works in the crypto markets, we use the Parkinson model. Unlike the close-to-close, the Parkinson model works very well in continuous markets. It looks at the high and the low of each day, and then applies a diffusion formula to back out the standard deviation. Some other common historical volatility calculation methods are the RSY method and the Yang and Zhang method. Those two other methods can be thought of as a blend between the Parkinson and the close-to-close method as an attempt to capture the properties of the Parkinson for non-continuous markets. As you can see, historical volatility is very important for options traders. It allows them to contextualize the implied volatility that the market is pricing. I hope today's lesson was helpful, and remember, find edge, capture alpha, and slank size.